In this video, we're going to be talking all about the four common questions front-end developers get and the answers to go along with them to help you in your next interview. And stay tuned to the end to hear about the free webinar I have to help you master the interview, along with the framework I use to answer the questions today and how you can do it too. And if you like content like this, make sure you hit the subscribe and notification bell to get more content like this in the future. My name is Jason Humphrey. I help developers stuck in their coding careers by teaching them how to master the interview so they ultimately can get the job of their dreams. In total, we're going to cover four questions today. What is Ajax? What is responsive design? The pros and cons of Node? And what is a RESTful API? Let's jump right into the first one. What is Ajax? The reason why we are asking this Ajax question is it is extremely crucial for you as a front-end developer to know how to communicate between a client and a server. More than likely, the employer will want to validate that you know how to do that because everybody's apps nowadays rely on data. And if you can't get the data or know how to work with the data, well, we have a problem. So let's get into the question. Ajax is asynchronous JavaScript and XML. Ajax communicates by transferring data between the client and the server using XHR, which stands for XML HTTP request. Ajax is like a phone call. Once you dial the phone number and hit send, the request is sent off and it comes back with someone on the other line. You don't have to worry about how it transfers the data at all. All you have to think about is what to say and to do next, much like your code. Ultimately, the experience the world gets from the internet that we know and love would not be possible without asynchronous JavaScript and XML. The next question is responsive design. What is it? Now, why are we asking about responsive design? Well, we are asking about responsive design here because as a front-end developer, it's not just about building logic for you. It's not just about connecting to APIs. It's also about designing the user experience that will ultimately get the customers to enjoy your product. We have to prove to your potential employer that you know how to build responsive designs based on the user experience they've asked for. So let's get into the question. Responsive web design is an approach to web design that makes the web pages render well on a variety of devices and window screens and sizes. This is all done by creating elements that respond differently when using things like Flexbox, media queries, and responsive libraries. If we look back at how we used to do it years ago, you would see how you basically had to build two sites, one for your main domain and a second for the mobile domain. Now, building out an entire responsive site can take more time in the upfront costs of hours because as a developer, you have to design and implement all the different viewports you want to support. But in the end, the payoff will be huge because of the experience your customers will receive and the time the team will get back in the long run. On to the next question. What are the pros and cons of Node.js? The reason here why we're talking about the pros and cons of Node is more or less to point out that the pros and cons question can be asked on any technology you have, but it's becoming more apparent as front-end developers with React or Angular that you have to know how to use something such as Node. It's no longer just JavaScript, HTML, and CSS. You have to be able to know one of these front-end frameworks that ultimately require Node. Now let's jump into the pros and cons of Node. Node.js is a runtime environment based off Chrome's V8 engine. It allows you to write server-side code with JavaScript. Let's go through some pros and cons, starting with the pros. It has an async event-driven IO, which helps it with concurrent requests on a single thread. The next pro is that it is using the language of JavaScript, which opens the doors for a lot of developers to use Node.js. Next pro is it has the largest package management system in the world with NPM, and it's completely open source and free for anyone to use and to publish packages. The last pro here is that Node.js is extremely good at short iterative requests because of its architecture. A majority of apps in the world only need short iterative requests, so Node fits the bill for a lot of applications. Let's go to the other side of the spectrum. Let's talk about some cons. First and foremost, the biggest con we have is scaling. Since it's single-threaded, it doesn't scale the best. The second con is it doesn't do well with CPU-intensive tasks. And the next con I have for you is that as good as NPM is in the open source world is for Node, it's also its biggest con. And I say that because of how malicious code can be potentially injected into the network. And last but not least, from a cons perspective, it doesn't do that well with unhandled error exceptions that most developers don't know how to catch properly, nor is it discussed about or easily implemented for you to make sure you're catching everything. More often than not, it'll just error out and kill the program. My experience with Node over the last 5 years has been absolutely amazing and has done amazing things for me as a developer. Not only have I joined a thriving community that I've now integrated with fully, I have been able to give back to the community with some of my own NPM packages, where on average I get about 1 million downloads per year of people using my software. On to the next question. What is a RESTful API? Now, why are we asking what is a RESTful API here? And it's because your employer not only wants to know that you can connect through Ajax from the client to the server, but they want to know you know how to integrate with a well-designed API. And like I said in the last one with Node.js, it's becoming also more apparent for front-end developers that you sometimes have to go build out your own RESTful APIs in Node.js. Because even though this video is called full stack and we're talking about full stack things, full stack developers are more often than not becoming full stack developers because of Node. And we have to know how to build out an API or how to use a properly formatted API such as a RESTful architecture. Let's get into the question of what is RESTful. REST stands for Representational State Transfer. It's an architectural approach to designing web services. The common HTTP methods used by most RESTful web APIs are GET, PUT, POST, DELETE, and PATCH. Now, in my experience, the beauty of using a properly designed RESTful API is that you know a couple of things. And by that I mean the methods will start to paint a really good picture of the API and how to use it. For example, we know we get a GET method and the route is API/blog/whatever the ID is, I know by that I will get one item back. If I take the ID off, I know I will get all blogs back. If I make it a put route with the ID, I will update something. Or if I change it to a post method, it will create. If you like content like this, make sure you hit the thumbs up, hit the subscribe and notification bell to get more content like this in the future. If you're wanting to learn more about how I answer the questions today and how I use the DICE framework in today's answers, then check out the webinar link down below. I'm going to be teaching you everything you need to know in those webinars about how to master the interview. And I cover the DICE technique in depth so that you can answer questions like today extremely easily with the DICE framework. Now, there's one thing I want to point out with the webinar. It is completely free, but I've limited the slots because I've made it free. So if you're interested in joining in, I would sign up while there's still spots open. And the beauty of this webinar is once you've signed up, you will get a recording even if you can't show up on the night of. In summary today, I ask these four questions of you and tell you the answers because I want you to know that they're all strategically there. Whether you know how to communicate to APIs to get the data, or you know the pros and cons of a specific language, or last but not least, you know how to design and work with certain architectures.